Then we have the next story, also mentioned at the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. There was a man known as Qarun. Qarun was very, very wealthy. Allah says in the Quran,
إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ.
Allah says, indeed, Qarun was from amongst the people of Musa alayhi salam. But he had transgressed. He had engaged in transgression against them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we had blessed him with so much wealth. The description Allah gives, he says, if a group of strong men had to carry, they would find it difficult to carry only the keys to his treasures. That's how much we'd given him. Look at the description. Allah says, if a group of strong people had to lift only the keys to his treasures, they would find it difficult to carry those keys. Imagine, today you've got one credit card. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. One little card and it sorts your problem. And here we have, Allah says, look how much real wealth we gave this man. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says, he had one problem. What was his problem? Haughtiness, arrogance. He says,
قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي.
That was his problem. He says, all this wealth I got, it's because of me. My brain, my intellect, my plan, my deal. I was the one who was witty. I was the one who did this. It was me and I am the big earner and I am the one who succeeded and it was only my effort and I and me. Allahu Akbar. That was him. He never related anything that he received or earned to Allah. Nothing at all. Everything was me.
إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ.
When his people, the people around him told him, hey, make sure that this does not result in your arrogance. You're becoming too happy here. This happiness which is beyond the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a haughtiness. Don't be haughty. Allah does not like those who are haughty in this particular way, despising other people, thinking that you can do what you want only because you've got the money. But no, he says, it's me. I made the plan. I am the one. I serve the people. People are earning because of me. I am the big king. I am the boss. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to fix him. But before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fixed him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that there were certain people. They looked at his wealth.
يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ.
Oh, we wish we had what Qarun was given. Indeed, he has a great share, a very big share. Look at his share. He's got so much. How we wish we had that.
وقال الذين أوتوا العلم ويلكم ثواب الله خير لمن آمن وعمل صالحا.
The people who had knowledge told these others who were wishing for the wealth of Qarun, don't do that. Indeed, the good deeds are better for you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't wish for what Allah's given him. Allah's given it to him, but he is a transgressor. So we cannot wish for that type of wealth. We cannot wish for that. Our eyes should not extend to that which Allah has blessed some people in a way that we want it for ourselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and save us from greed. And may Allah make us content with what we have. These knowledgeable people were saying, if you do good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is better for you. And Allah says this in the Quran in more places.
وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا.
In a few places in the Quran, Allah says, those extra deeds, those tasbihat, those acts of worship that you do, those are better in the eyes of Allah than all your wealth and your children that you have in this world. May Allah grant us steadfastness. So Allah says after that,
فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِئَةٍ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُنْتَصِرِينَ.
We caused the earth to swallow him up with everything he owned. Everything was swallowed. In the morning the people saw everything was gone totally. Qarun and his cronies together with his properties, together with all his wealth, everything was swallowed by the earth. Out. And Allah says, nobody could help him against Allah. He couldn't help himself and nothing could assist him at all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this man used to boast and he used to brag about his wealth and he used to show it off and pretend like, you people don't have, I have, you know. And people wanted to copy him. We said that in the Quran moments ago. Some people said, we want like him. So when he had something, everyone else wanted it. When he had that type of a vehicle, few members in the community wanted it. Now the vehicle is the example of our life here. Why do we give it? Because we need to know that we have a sickness sometimes. We want to follow the rich and famous. Everything they do, we want to do. Those who are above us, according to us, in terms of dunya, we want to do. Why don't we think for a moment, let us try and adopt the lifestyle of those who are more religious than us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our doors. So Allah says after that,
وأصبح الذين تمنوا مكانه بالأمس يقولون ويك أن الله يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء من عباده ويقدر لولا أن من الله علينا لخسف بنا ويك أنه لا يفلح الكافرون.
In the morning, the people who were wishing to have the wealth that he had, when they got up, they saw what had happened, that he was completely non-existing, swallowed up by the earth, and they said, Ya Allah, you give wealth to whomsoever you wish, just as well we didn't get this wealth. Had we been given the wealth similar to Fir'aun, today we would have also been sucked in or eaten up, swallowed up by the earth, just like he has. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.